Good morning. Thank you for connecting. For connecting to be here serves as a reminder to all of us just how important our work is. Our mission is to surrender to God. My name is Pastor Daryl Hayden, and it's my privilege and pleasure on behalf of High Street Christian Church to welcome you here today. We are delighted to have you to worship with us, to participate, and to share in our service. Welcome and good morning to all the mothers and all those who abide. Happy Mother's Day. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever.
Christian brothers and sisters, happy to have you all here today with us. First of all, I'd like to wish a happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. God has been good to most of us, blessed us to have beautiful, loving, caring mothers that raised us and cared for us throughout our lives. So I just again want to wish all the mothers out there happy Mother's Day. This is your day. Be blessed. Let us come to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, we give thanks, O dear Lord, that you gave us the strength this day, O Heavenly Father, to rise from our beds and to come before you, O Heavenly Father, to give praise, honor, and glory to you and your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you, O dear Lord, for sending Christ to this world. Heavenly Father, he led us as the shepherd of the flock, O Heavenly Father. He taught us, O Heavenly Father. Let us live by his example, Heavenly Father. He was persecuted by man, O Heavenly Father. He suffered and he died on the cross, Heavenly Father. He went to hell, Heavenly Father. But on your promise, he rose on the third day, O Heavenly Father, to show us, O dear Lord, that we would have life eternal if we just follow him. Let us be strong in our faith, O Heavenly Father, and believe that he is the ultimate Savior. Heavenly Father, we give thanks for the many blessings you bestowed upon us, for the food on our table, the clothes on our backs, the roofs over our heads, the cars that we drive, O Heavenly Father. We give thanks, O dear Lord, that you've been with us. Heavenly Father, we just ask that you continue to be with us as we deal with this coronavirus pandemic, O Heavenly Father. We pray for those that have gone on because of that, O Heavenly Father. We pray for those that are in their sick beds still because of it, O Heavenly Father. We give thanks for those that have recovered, O Heavenly Father. We pray for those that are on the front lines, O Heavenly Father, the doctors and the nurses, firefighters and the EMTs and the workers at the stores, oh Heavenly Father. We pray for all those that are still trying to protect us and keep us safe. We pray for the politicians and ask that you would just instill instill a sense of your spirit in them, Heavenly Father, that they can make the right decisions, oh dear Lord. Help us be one together, Heavenly Father. Let us not let politics divide us in this situation. Let us come together and deal with this situation, Heavenly Father, as you would have us to be brothers and sisters. Dear Lord, again we give thanks for all that you've done for us, Heavenly Father. We just ask that you be with us, Heavenly Father. Keep our faith strong, oh Heavenly Father, this day, oh Heavenly Father. We give thanks that you are with us and ask that you be with us today and be with all our mothers today, oh Heavenly Father. For it's in your Son Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Awesome. Mighty provider.
mighty. And we're so thankful and grateful for his word and what he does for us in our lives each and every day. He is an awesome God, a mighty God, a God that can do anything but fail in all of our lives. As we come to celebrate Mothers this day, we just thank God for his word that kept some of our mothers when they were struggling through, a word that kept our families together, a word that we can rely on even in the midst of all of our troubles. I don't mean some of those pity-any troubles, but I mean some troubles that we get deep down in. And nobody can help us but God. And so we thank him and we praise him and honor him today. Our scripture text comes from Psalms 31. Psalms 31, 1 through 5. And it reads as follows. In you, O Lord, I put my trust. Let me never be ashamed. Deliver me in your righteousness. Bow down your ear to me. Deliver me speedily. Be my rock of refuge, a fortress of defense to save me. For you are my rock and my fortress. Therefore, for your name's sake, lead me and guide me. Pull me out of the net which thou hast secretly laid for me. For you are my strength. Into your hand I commit my spirit. You have redeemed me, O Lord God of truth. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and hearing of his holy and righteous word. We'll have a next selection by Sister Carolyn Bruton, a dedication to mothers at this time. Thank you. Psalms 31:1-5, from the theme, My Strong Rock. For even here, this was a vivid look into David going through or struggling with something. Another writer puts it, it was a bird who was seeking refuge under his mother's wing. This morning, I want to talk to you as if the bird was seeking refuge under his mother's wing. For even in the text it says, in you, O Lord, I put my trust. Let me never be ashamed. Deliver me in your righteousness. For we are reminded that the Lord that we serve, the God that we serve is a deliverer. One who keeps us. One who keeps his hands upon us, even in our very time of struggle. Even in the very time when we need him the most. Even in the very time when we haven't lived up or been everything that we should have been in life. Even when we're struggling trying to make it in life. Even when we're trying to find our way, our path in life. He is a deliverer. We have to be reminded even today as people go through life. People are trying to find their way. Some people have to go around the mountain the long way. Some people have to go around the mountain in the valleys. Some people have to go down and through a way that we don't see how possibly they can make it. But God we serve is a deliverer. He's a deliverer. We have to be reminded of that he delivers us in all of our troubles, in all of our struggles, no matter how heavy the load gets. I'm not talking about none of that little everyday stuff. I'm talking about some struggles in life that we have to go through that people under certain normal circumstances could not make it. He is a deliverer. He delivers us. Even here the bird is talking about, in you, O Lord, I put my trust. Let me never be ashamed. Deliver me in your righteousness. He's seeking deliverance. He's seeking to be delivered from the hand of the enemy. How many of you know, even today, our children are facing some things that we never thought about facing in life. He is a deliverer. Not just our children, but what we face every day. The struggles in life that we're going through, even in this time of a pandemic, the struggles that we have to be reminded, he is a deliverer. Yeah, knowing that he's a deliverer, he's our strong rock. That means that he never moves. He never wavers in his being. He's always the same today, yesterday, and forever. He never wavers. You can trust God to be there. You can trust God to be right on our side. You can trust God to be all that he can be for us in our life. You can trust God. He is a strong rock in our lives. He's a strong rock. Yeah. In his strength, he delivers us. In his strength, He will never forsake us. It is strength. No matter how far we get from him, he's always there. Have you ever got so far from your mother that your mother can go out in the street and just call your name? And you can hear it all over town, wherever you at. When they call your name, you can hear her voice. And that's how God is. He's a deliverer. He's crying out for us today. He is crying out for those who are lost today. He's a deliverer. We have to be reminded that he'll never forsake us. He's always on our side. Yeah. No matter how heavy the load gets. Come on, Sister Carolyn. Psalms 22, 1 through 5. And it says this.
My God, why hast thou forsaken me?
Stop right there. You remember Jesus, don't you? When he was up on the cross, he cried out these same words that David cried out. He cried out these same words. My God, why thou hast, when the load of agony and death and sin and iniquity gets so heavy on us. How many of you know, but he never forsaken us. He's a God who delivers us. No matter how heavy the load gets, he delivers us. Yeah. Yeah. Jesus himself used the same words. He echoed David from Psalms 22. My God, why thou hast forsaken. The same words. He echoed the agony of death, the heaviness of death, the heaviness of sin and iniquity, the heaviness of you and me being on his back. Yeah. He substituted himself for us. Jesus did. Yeah. How many of you know that gets heavy sometimes? But he did it anyway. And he would not come down. Come on, come on, come on.
Why art thou so far from helping me and from the words of my roaring? Oh my God, I cry in the daytime, but thou hearest not, and in the night season, and am not silent.
Here you go. He said, I cry out all day and all night long, and look like you're not answering quick enough for me. But how many of you know he's always an on-time God? You can shout right where you at. He's an on-time God. He always shows up and he hears us. He's our help in our very time of trouble. He's an on-time God. When I need him the most, he's already taking care of me. He's a deliverer. He delivers us no matter how heavy the load. He hears us. He hears us even in our night season. He hears us when we don't think nobody else is around. Even when we think we're sneaking up, he hears us and he knows all. Yeah. Said, I'm not silent. Said, I'm not silent. Come on.
But thou art holy, O thou that inhabitest the praises of Israel. Our fathers trusted in thee. They trusted, and thou didst deliver them.
And how many of you know we got to trust him? We have to trust him because he will deliver us. We have to trust him because he is our deliverer. How many of you know that our fathers trusted him, our mothers trusted him, and guess what? We have to trust him today. He is our deliverer. No matter how bleak or how bad it looks, he is our deliverer. How many of you know God specializes in the impossible? He is our deliverer. Yeah. He is our deliverer. I've seen him take cancer and put cancer in its place. I've seen him take financial trouble and put financial trouble in its place. I've seen him take broken hearts and mend a broken heart. I've seen him bring joy in sorrow. He is a deliverer. I've seen him be a friend to the friendless. He is our deliverer. Yeah. Whatever you're seeking, whatever you're seeking today, he can deliver.
Come on, finish up.
They cried unto thee and were delivered. They trusted in thee and were not confounded.
And when you trust in God, he makes everything all right. I didn't say when you trust in yourself on what you've done, how you pulled yourself up by your own bootstrap. I'm talking about when you trust in God. Yeah. He's righteous to deliver us. He's righteous to bring us back to where he wants us to be. He is righteous. He is righteous. He is righteous to deliver us right where he wants us to be. Yeah. Anytime you go to count him out, look like he can come through for you. Anytime you go to throw in the towel, look like he can make a way out of no way. Anytime you think that you can't make it, the God that I serve is a deliverer. I declare, if you hold on to him, trust in him. Yeah, he can make everything all right. Yeah. He can make everything all right. Yeah. Yeah. It said, bow down. Second verse says, bow down your ear to me. Deliver me speedily. He always, always delivers. All we have to do is trust him. I declare, in 2020, on May 10th, I'm going to trust him more today than I did yesterday. I've seen what he's able to do. I see how he can make a way out of no way. I see what he's able and how he keeps us. And let me declare it unto you, no matter how bad that COVID gets, Jesus is still a healer. I'm going to trust him. I'm going to trust him more today. Yeah. Trust him. Trust him. Trust him more today. Yeah. He's that kind of God. He's that kind of deliverer. He said, even in the text, he said, bow down your ear to me, deliver me speedily. He said, not on my time, but on your time, deliver me. How many of you know it's something about his righteousness? His righteousness shows up. His righteousness. It's something about when you live a righteous and victorious life, his righteousness shows up. Yeah, even when the enemy tries to stop you, it's something about his righteousness shows up. Luke 23, 46 through 49. Yeah.
And when Jesus had cried with loud voice, he said, Father, into thy hand I commend my spirit. And having said this, he gave up the ghost. Now when the centurion saw what had done, he glorified God, saying, certainly this was a righteous man.
Stop right there. The centurion soldier, when he saw it for himself, he wasn't a believer, but when he saw it for himself, how many of you know he can turn? He can even turn the hardest of hearts around. All we have to do is recognize the righteousness of God. He said this was a righteous man. How many of you know when he gave up the ghost, he commanded his spirit back to the heavenly Father, the centurion saw this man in a whole new light. How many of you realize if we just trust God enough, he will show up in our lives and the righteousness that's within him will come within us. And guess what? Folks will see the Jesus in us. Woo! Not that we may be glorified, but that he may be glorified. He's a righteous man. The centurion soldier was paid to tell everything else but that. But let me tell you, no money on earth could stop you from realizing the righteousness
Yeah. He said, wasn't it certainly a righteous man? And it's something about his righteousness that we can seek refuge in. For he's our rock in a weary land. A rock of refuge. A rock of safetyness. A rock of solidness. A rock that we can depend on. A rock that we can hold on to. Even when the bird is thrown out of the nest, it's something about realizing that they're under their mother's wing. It's the righteousness. Something about realizing that the rock is there. Something to realize the rock is all. If you can't go nowhere else, you can always go back to your mother. The rock is there. When you can't depend on nobody else, you can always depend on your mother. The rock is there. Even in our Christian walk today, we have to learn how to understand that he's our strong rock. It's something about his righteousness that the rock shows up, that he's our refuge. He's our fortress of defense. He saves us. This rock is Jesus, the rock that we can hold on to, the rock that we can depend on. Yeah. Yeah. And look like every time we need him, we can call on the rock. Every time we need him, we can say Jesus, and he answers. Every time we need him, we can say Emmanuel, and he's there. Every time we need him. That rock is there. He's that cornerstone that we need. Even when it looks like we don't have a way out, he holds us up and holds us together. Somebody ought to hear me today. He keeps his hands up. He keeps us from losing our mind. He's a strong rock. He's a strong rock. Centurion said, this is a righteous man. Come on, Elder, finish that verse for me.
And all the people that came together to that sight, beholding the thing which was done, smote their breasts and returned, and all his acquaintance and the women that followed him from Galilee stood far off, beholding these things.
I don't care how far you get, you can't miss the hand of a righteous man of God. I don't care how far you think you are from him, you can recognize his righteousness. I don't care how far you think or how you don't think you know him, he knows you. You cannot miss his righteousness. I don't care if you don't want to get close enough where that you can get burned by the fire, you can still receive and see his righteousness, because he's a rock in a weary land. Even when storms of life are raging around, he's a rock. His righteousness. His righteousness. He said they were stood afar off. They couldn't help but see. He's a rock. I don't know about you. Even in life today, even when things just don't go as like you want them to go, and you don't think you can have the right to call upon it, it's something about his amazing grace. You can stand as far away from him if you want to, but you can't miss the righteousness, the rock showing up. You can't miss. Cannot miss this righteous man, this rock showing up in your life. Third verse says, you are my rock and my fortress, therefore, for your name's sake, lead me and guide me. Yeah. He'll lead you and guide you. And when you're not walking on your own,
Oh, my friends, when you don't walk on your own strength and walk on the strength of this righteous man called the rock, look like the load gets lighter. Look like you get new energy. Look like he brings you through another day, and that you, a day that you never thought you would make it through. Look like he can bring joy and happiness in the middle of your sorrow. I tell you, 2020, that's what we need right now. Joy and happiness. Yeah. This rock. Yeah. Said he would lead you and guide you. Yeah. That means you're not walking on your own. That means he's taking care of you. That means you can lay down at night knowing that this righteous man, this rock, will cover you and keep you safe from all hurt, harm, and energy, injury. Yeah, this rock. Yeah. When man tells you no, he'll tell you yes. This rock. When man counts you out, he'll lift you up. He said, I'll make the enemies your footstool. He'll lift you up over your enemies. This rock. This rock that I'm talking about will bring you through another storm. Yeah, this rock. Yeah. Yeah. Prudential used to say, have a piece of the rock. I declare this morning, have all the rock. Yeah. Used to be a life insurance company, be Prudential. And you said, get a piece of the rock. Get all the rock. Get a rock that will hold you, a rock that will sustain you in the midst of your storm, a rock that can change you in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. A rock. A rock. Even when the nets are pulled all around you, it says, pull me out of the net which they have secretly laid for me. Even those things that have been laid up for you that you didn't see coming. That rock, he can speak. That rock, he's a bridge over troubled water. That rock, he'll bring your children safely through. The rock, he'll keep his hands upon you. The rock, even if you don't think you got a job, the rock. Yeah, the rock, the rock, your rock, said even pull me out of the nets that will have secretly laid for me, for you are my strength, you are my rock, you are my rock. Even when somebody has dug a ditch for me, pull me out. You're my rock. You're my rock. Yeah. See, all the time in life, we have to make sure that we understand that we're following God. He leads us and guides us. We want to follow. Why? Because he's our rock. What assurance we have when we're following him that he will always take care of us. He's our rock. When we can't take care of ourselves, when we lead it, let him lead and guide us, he'll take care of us. He's our rock. He's our rock. He's our rock. We have to understand that we're not walking on our own, but we're following after the rock. Yeah. Said you must strength the rock. Oh, isn't that good news? No matter how far we stand away from him, we can see the righteousness of that man and realizing that he's our rock. He's our rock. He'll take care of us. Yeah. He's our rock. That's good news. That's good news.
Come on, elders. Deuteronomy 32, 1 through 4.
Give ear, O ye heavens, and I will speak, and hear, O earth, the words of my mouth. My doctrine shall drop as a rain. My speech shall distill as a dew, and the small rain upon the tender earth, and as the showers upon the grass. Because I will publish the name of the Lord, ascribe ye greatness unto our God. He is the rock.
Stop right there. Moses, I talked a little bit about it the other day. Moses here is talking about God as their rock. And as the children of Israel is going through and trying to get to that place where he's leading and guiding them, they have to remember that God is their rock. He said, give ear, O heavens, and I will speak. And hear where he talks about the rain will fall. And he didn't hold the rain back from none of us. Yeah. He said, I'll publish the name. I'll make your name known. Today we have to proclaim the name of Jesus everywhere we go. He's our rock. We have to proclaim it. That Jesus is our rock. That he's our savior. He's our righteous man. That Jesus is our rock. That he died and got up on the third day with our power in heaven and earth in his hand. He's our rock. He's our rock. Moses was proclaiming it to the children of Israel as he was leading them out. He was proclaiming that God is their rock. You can't make it without God on your side. He's our rock. I don't care how far you think you've got from him, he's still there. Every time you turn around, there's God. When you go to sleep at night, there's God. There's God. There's God. Just give me that next phrase, Elder. Yeah, don't give me all. Just give me the next word. That's right there.
He is the rock. His work is perfect.
Stop right there. His work is perfect. In all of our fallacies, in all of our shortcomings, his work is perfect. He don't make mistakes. He's our rock. He's perfect. His work is perfect. And I don't know about you, but I declare it more today. The name of Jesus is more in control today than ever before. No matter how hard man's hearts get. His work is perfect. He's our rock. He's our rock. He's our rock. Come on.
For all his ways are judgment, a God of truth and without iniquity, just and right is he.
God of truth without sin. Yeah. His work is perfect. Yeah. It says in that fifth verse, into your hand I commit my spirit. You have redeemed me, O God of truth. We all can recall when Jesus used those words. And also Stephen, before his death, he used those same words. You remember when they stoned Stephen for being a follower of God. The same time when you proclaim it today, people will look at you funny. But I'm telling you, the only way you're going to make it is through the rock. His ways are truth. His ways are right. His ways are just. The rock. Yeah. Yeah. You talk to some mothers today, they'll tell you the only way they made it was because of the rock. Because his ways are truth. He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. He's the one that put food on our table, clothes on our back, roof over our head. The rock. We wouldn't be here if it wasn't for him on our side. The rock. Yeah. We declare today, he's an awesome God. He's powerful in all his ways. Yeah. 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 Jesus was upon the cross, and when he gave it up, he says, "Into your hands I commit my spirit. You have redeemed me, O Lord, God of truth." He's our Redeemer. When we have no way out, he's our Redeemer. When we don't have nowhere else to turn, he's our Redeemer. When we don't have nowhere else to go, he's our Redeemer. Oh, let him in today. He's our rock. He's our rock. He's our rock. He's our rock. Yeah. And he's just not a pebble, but he's my rock, a strong rock. Yeah. He can stand under pressure. He's that kind of rock. You know how some people, when the pressure comes, they leave you high and dry? This God I serve can stand under pressure. You know how some people say, "I'm with you, baby." And soon as baby gets in trouble, they leave. But he stands under pressure. He's a strong rock. Never leave us. Always there for all of us. No matter how far we think we are from him, he's right there. He's right there with us. Yeah. Yeah. There's God. He's right there. Yeah. 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 No matter how heavy the load gets, there's our rock. We thank you. Thank you, Lord. Maybe there's one who's out of the ark of safety. Need to realize that he's your rock. We invite you today. We invite you to open up your heart and let the rock come into your life. I'm a witness, you'll never be the same. I stand tall on that. You'll never be the same. You let him in. You'll never be the same. You let him have control. You'll never be the same. I'm a witness. I'm a witness that he can change things. Turn things around and work things out for your good. Never be the same. Somebody said, he'll blow your mind. Let him in. Never be the same. He's mind-blowing. He's life-changing. Never be the same. Yeah. 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 Whole lot of times folk run around here as if they have no hope. He restores all that back to you. Never, ever the same. Never the same. Never the same. Never the same. Never. Because he's a strong rock. Never the same. Never the same. have any prayer requests this morning, but he's never, ever the same. He changes you. You're never the same. Nobody like him. Nobody like him. We want to lift up Sister Georgie Cunningham, Brother Freddie Mack and the Norris family, Sister Violet Goodpasture, the whole world over, Jonathan, Allen, and Kobe, the Frazier family, Sister Pamela Frazier. When you let the rock in, it's never the same. Never the same. Keisha and Emmanuel, never the same. Warner Jean and the Warner family, Charlene Carr. When you let the rock in your life, never, ever the same. I declare you're not the same anymore. Sister Mary Roberts, Second Christian Church, Midway, Kentucky. The Rawls and Scott family. You're never the same. The Henrys, the Haydens, the Castings, the Fletchers. You're never the same. High Street Christian Church family. Never the same. I don't care how bad it looked. Look like when you got the rock on your side. Prudential said, you just need a piece. I declare this morning, you need the whole rock. The whole rock. It's kind of like, I just don't want him to bless me. I want him to bless me all over. Not just my hands, not just my feet, but bless me all over. Rock. Mona Ashby, Jameel Owens. He's a rock. He's a rock. You can't do it without him. He's a rock. How many of you know he eases the load? When it gets heavy, the rock eases the load. Woo! The rock. Shall we pray? Gracious and loving and wise God, we thank you. Thank you for sending down your son Jesus so that we might have the chance to the tree of life. Thank you that he can turn darkness into day. Thank you that we can see the righteousness of him. No matter how far we are from him, we can see him calling us by name. We're crying out to him this morning. Thank you for being God in our life. He's a redeemer. The one that we can hold on to. The one that answers prayer. The one that can bring us through. Even when we out there and don't know which way to go. Even when we're going down the wrong road, he can turn us around and bring us back to himself because he's a rock. And we can witness his goodness and his mercy and his might because he's the rock. He's the rock in our weary land. He's our rock. Even when our families have been tossed and turned upside down, he's a rock that can bring us through. He's our rock. So we thank him, we praise him, we honor him, and we glorify him for all his many wonderful blessings. Be with us, Lord, as we go through this COVID-19. Be with us as they open doors, letting us back, that people will be respectful of other people. Help us, Lord, as we go through. Give us more love, a better understanding one with another, that we can trust you all the more, because you are rock. We thank you for bringing some of these mothers through when they were all by themselves and all they had were their children and the men have left them. Thank you, Lord, for bringing them through. Thank you, Lord, for putting food on the tables and clothes on the back and roof over their head. Thank you, God, for showing your awesomeness. Even when their children were out there doing everything under the sun, it wasn't nobody but you, Lord. Nobody but you, Lord, that kept them. So we thank you, praise you, and honor you today. For you are strength. Keep us, Lord. In these things we pray. Amen. Thank you.
into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you.
This is why I love you. Because you love me.
Like our hearts intertwine into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you.
We wish to thank Elder Gene Caston for putting that together for us. And for all of you who sent in pictures, we'd like to thank you who took part in this. You can also retrieve a copy of this on Facebook and also on YouTube after service today. You will be able to retrieve this to have for yourself. We thank God for all these women who have shared in our lives, those who are gone and those who are still here. And so we ask that all of you have a wonderful Mother's Day in remembering all the goodness and the mercies of your mothers, what they've done. Elder Cassie, you want to add anything to that?
We'll post the link on YouTube later today, and we'll also repost the video on Facebook again for those that like to watch it again.
Amen. We come to the most important part of our service, and that is the Lord's Supper. It's not ours to say who shall or who shall not take of these emblems, for it was the Lord who laid down his body and picked it up again. We celebrate not just his death, but we celebrate the resurrection and also the ascension back into heaven. We know we can't make it without him, and so we glorify him for all that he's doing in our lives, and not just our lives, but our neighbors and our neighbors' children and our families' lives. We give him the honor and the glory today. People of God, he's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy to be praised. On the night Jesus was betrayed, he gathered his disciples around him. He took the bread and gave thanks. He took the cup and gave thanks. He said, as often as you do this, do this in remembrance of me. Shall we pray? Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for the bread that was sacrificed for us to have life and have life more abundantly. We thank you for the blood that was sacrificed to wash us, to make us new, to cleanse us. We give you all the glory and all the praise. We thank you for that time that you came in and sent your son that we might have life and have it more abundantly. So we offer up the sacrifice of praise today to you. You're an awesome and mighty God. In these things we pray. Amen. He took the loaf, he gave thanks, and they all ate together. Shall we eat? They all drink together. Shall we drink? The blood for the remission of our sins. Then afterwards they sung the hymn and went out. We want to thank all of you for being here today and taking the time to patiently listen to what I had to say. And also we want to thank all those who have been contributing and their offering and love gifts. It has been special to see the Lord work these days. And so, Father, we just thank him and we praise him for you, for opening up your hearts and your minds to give back to him. We also have set up a Venmo account for those who would like to send money through Venmo. You just go into High Street Christian Church under Venmo, and that you're able to give that away. We thank those who've already given through Venmo. I wish you all a blessed day, a blessed Mother's Day, and a happy day. Amen. Amen. And amen.